So in this question, we're given that 76% of the students are likely to go to engineering college. 63% are likely to go to a medical college, and X percent are likely to go to both engineering and medical colleges. If that is so, what can you say about the number X? So in terms of sets, if you say that E is the set of students who are likely to go to engineering colleges, so N of E is equal to 76. If we say that there are a total of 100 students, if we say that there are a total of 100 students, N of E is equal to 76 and N of M is equal to 63 and N of E intersection M is equal to X, right? Now, from these three, what can you talk about N of E union M? N of E union M, from the formula, is N of E plus N of M minus N of E intersection M. That is equal to 139 minus X. Now, what can you say about N of E union M? N of E union M, which is 139 minus X, should always be less than or equal to 100, right? Because there are a total of 100 students. So, combinedly E and M cannot be more than 100 students. So, N of E union M has to be always less than or equal to 100. That means X has to be always greater than or equal to 39. This is the first condition. Next, what else can you say? N of E union M, which is 139 minus X, will always be greater than or equal to 76, because there are 76 students who are going to engineering college alone. So if I combine the students going to engineering college and medical college, can that number be less than 76? No, right? It has to be greater than or equal to 76, because in E union M, you have all the students who are going to engineering colleges and all the students who are going to medical colleges. So this number cannot be less than 76. So it has to be greater than or equal to 76. Hence, X has to be less than or equal to 139 minus 76. That is, X less than or equal to 63. That means X has to be greater than or equal to 39 and less than or equal to 63. That means option C is the right answer.